their natural habitat without disturbing them. And also we can provide the shelter or whatever the living conditions is there, that should be provided to them, that is defined as the wildlife sanctuaries. So we are in the same baby step of the wild sanctuaries, we can be seen. So maybe in this wildlife sanctuaries they can be included in the forest. So whatever forest area is there, we can be conserved with that one. So we have to have whatever people should be lying in that condition, they can be due to the opportunity for the grazing of animals, and also they can be collect the firewood and also medicinal plants. So they can be provided in this area, we can provide the opportunity of animals also, and also we can be killing of animals or entertaining purpose, so we can be not to kill the animals and also their whatever their habitat is there, we cannot be disturbed to that one. So Indians, why they are such as wide, so they have the wider area, so maybe they have the landscape, so landscape, so some have a mountain area, some have a hilly area, so some of the delta can be part of the, so in human areas, so whatever can be seen, so that is the we can be delta area, so all area can be concerned with that, that is the we can be part of the wildlife. So they can be big areas, they can be caught open. So they provide the several wild animals like maybe you can be called as the pink or painted cock. So pink painted cock, rhinoceros, and also you can be seen in the some type of the elephants. So those are the extinct or extinct in the features, so that type of the animals we can be considered to this area, elephant, rhinoceros, so like that we can be covered as, so like that animals we can be seen here. So in our country we have the nearly 543 type of the sanctuaries we can be seen. So how many can be seen? Nearly 543 wildlife sanctuaries. So under that one, 52 should be project for tigers. So 52 wildlife sanctuaries, whatever there, so that should be used for the wildlife sanctuaries. So maybe for the first one is to be called as Jin Pape. So in India, we can be considered the tiger for the one that is called Jin Pape. So that name we can be come to the under two. So you can be seen from that one, Uttar Pradesh, so there is a Jin Pape, which is the conservation of the tigers in India, first time. So project tiger means the body should be decided to conserve the some of the species which have the extinct in the nature. So that should be conserved the particular area, that is the you can be called as the tiger body should be maybe started to that one. So they can be survived and maintain some of the their life in their natural habitat. So similarly, some of the wildlife sanctuaries we can be seen to that one. So for the Keladio, so some of the wildlife sanctuaries also we can be seen in the bird sanctuary also. So for example, Keladio, so which is you can be called as the bird sanctuaries, later you can be called as the wildlife sanctuaries. So that is why you can be called as the some of the we can be seen in the bird sanctuaries also. So they can be coming across that one, the national park also we can be announced to that one. So some of the national park also they can be conserved for both bird sanctuaries and also wildlife sanctuaries, that is we can call as the national park. So first one is national park. So what is the meaning of national park? So it means it can be conserved for both biosystem. So whatever they can be included. So it is one of the largest area of the forest area, and also whatever area that should be included. So maybe mountains, So we have to the daily steps of the national parks after our second day discuss that one. So there the here you can be seen in the not only the only forest area, so some of the rocky area also we can be seen to that one. The rocky area we can tell about the whatever the historic moment. So maybe those are the living in the tribal peoples, so they may be hunting or painting pictures, or we can be seen in the their dancing or they will be playing. So all these rocky structures also we can be seeing that that should be also we can be considered.
Also, we have the something of the ending
the board. So there are, which is known as the IUCN Red Data Board. So this book is also called as the IUCN Red Data Board. So here it can be classified into 9 groups under to this Red Data Group. One is the first one is estate. So estate means those are not evident. So no known location of the that animals. So the animals which have we do not know that one, that is the identified as the extinct species. And also extinct in wild. Extinct in wild means the animals which do not know the wilderness or forest area, that is the identified as the extinct wild. So next third one is which can be called as the extremely endangered. So critically endangered. So critically endangered is the species which will be endangered in the near. So that is the critical as the endangered species. The species which have the critically endangered. So that is the critically endangered species. Vulnerable means, so they will be both extinct and also non-extinct of the wild. So that is the critical as the vulnerable species of to that one. So near threatened. So near threatened is they are the concern to that one because they are already in the extinction species. So that is the reason we call it the near threatened. So fifth one is near threatened. So sixth one is least concerns. So least concerns means they have to the number of the pets and how many ones which have to the appearance in the nature. So that is the reason we call it the least concerns. It can be concerned of one. So that is the reason we call it the least concern. So the last one is, so some of the data deficiency. So data deficiency means, so we cannot be recording to that one. So we will not record the any that type of the facts and animals, how can be adapted to that one according to the rules of the IUCN. So that is the reason we call it the data deficiency. So these are the some of the groups we can be under the IUCN, extinct wild, critically endangered, and also vulnerable, near threatened, least concern, and data deficiency. So those are the extinct, critically endangered, and vulnerable. So that is the thing we more focus on the data. Because once their species is eradicated, so we cannot be seen to the near future also. Yes, we can be grown to the left side of the plants and animals in the wet area. So those are species are critically endangered, we can be seen to the wet. So next concept is migration. So what is the meaning of migration? So we can be migrated for various reasons from one place to another. Means moving from the one place to another place, maybe plants, so not plants, so animals, birds, human beings, for their natural disturbance, or they can be various reasons they can move from the one place to another place. So maybe it should be several kilometers, so that should be maybe temporary or permanently for the livelihood. That is the thing we call as the migration. So next one is migratory birds. So you know that about the some of the birds they can become across to the various countries to our country for their reproductive purpose and also their species purpose also they can be come to our India also. So our Indian birds also they can be go to the other countries also they can be seen in the. So what is the meaning of migratory birds is the birds that are fly to other area or other geographical area for several kilometers, maybe even 19,000 kilometers, like that they can be migrated to one part of the world or another part of the world also. So maybe for the climatic conditions between differences also they can be laid in lakes and also they can be reproductive with their own species. All these reasons they can be migrated from the one place to another places. So maybe in hospital conditions like that, so they can be avoid that one also, they can be come across to one place to another place. That is why we call it the migratory birds. So why should we recycling of papers? So next one is recycling of paper. So we can be used for the paper for the various purposes, maybe our 17 fully blown trees. 17 fully blown trees can be used to 1 ton of making up 1 ton of paper. So it means what? You can be cutting up the trees for the power consumption. So to avoid this one, at least you can be recycled the paper. So if you recycle or reuse the paper, so it should be what happened? Maybe it can be taken on the 6 to 7 trees. We can be saved on paper. So that is the more important thing. We can be paper saving also. And also we can be reducing our consumptions of the making of the paper for the labor charge or the factories or the whatever we can use to the harmful chemicals also we can use that one. That can be also we can be avoided in this one. So yes, we can be concerned for the this paper also. Unnecessary we cannot be used to that one. So nowadays what happens we can be used to the all our working the office whatever need paper we can be used to that one. So maybe in a ticket also whatever we can use that one. So we can ask all papers to be e-paper we can be sent to the mobiles also we can be used to that one. So next one is reforestation. So why it means reforestation? So reforestation means it is the opposite of the deforestation. So we can be whatever plants or plants we have cut down, so that place it can be again, it can be put again, it can be replace the some plants in that place. So that is the we can be called as the reforestation. So naturally when we cut the one or more trees, whatever, so again they can be grown in the same place. In case we can be cut the various type of the more number of the trees, so we can be regain or replace the that place. Regrowth of the plants is the reforestation. So because deforestation should be causes for maybe some of the if you construct the road or dams or any other project can be to that one. So some of the medicinal plants are some of the extinct animals, some of the extinct of the trees are there. That can be also we can be saved and also we can be grown in the other regions. So whatever we have to the some places are there that should be also we can that one. So yes, we can be deforestation. Because mineral deforestation should be go on that one in real whatever carbon dioxide should be very high and also global amount should be causes. So it should go not polluting in the area also. So we cannot be grown the that one area. So lastly, in this area, so we can be find about the sum of the name. So the name should be written called as the Java Pain. So Java paint so is the one of the Indian naturalist or you can be called as the one of the ecological balance of the urban. So here is the award in the 2015, that is the Padma Shri Award. So it is one of the Nobel Prize. So it can be given to the highest fourth civilization award. So this is the Padma Shri Award. So why it means, so it is the one of the Malay, it can be called as the Malay also. So because he is from the Johar, so he is coming from the Johar from the India. So he can be considered the one of the trees and also he can be putting the number of the trees and grass. So nearly 1,200 hectare of the land. So it will be those are nearly 1,350 hectares of land. So that should be called as the Malay also can be part of the covered. So because we can be cultivated this type of the plants in the near the Brahmaputra river. So that is it can be called as the Sambar. So Sambar near Brahmaputra river. So yes, it can be called as the Java Pain.